Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how easily you can drag, resize, and animate the Blazor dialog control. Also, I will show you how to create a custom dialog and add multiple dialogs to it. Look at this example, where you can see the subscription dialog with a message about a successful subscription. Now, I will show you how to achieve this customization at the code level. First, I will open an existing Blazor Dialog application, where I have already configured the Blazor Dialog with the properties, target, height, and width. In case you want to know how to add a dialog control to a Blazor application, I have linked the Getting Started video in the above YouTube card. You can also find the link in the description below. Now, I will run this application to show you the output of this example. So here, you can see the dialog with a custom height and width. Now, I am going to design a custom subscription dialog. First, I add a dialog templates and define the header, content, and footer template tags. Then, I set the header content as subscribe newsletter within this division element. Next, I add content for the dialog. So, let me define the division element with appropriate content. In the footer, I want to add a text box to collect email addresses and a button component for readers to subscribe to the newsletter. For that, I open the NuGet Package Manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I search for Syncfusion Blazor Inputs and Syncfusion Blazor Buttons in the Browse tab and install the package in my project. Next, I import the buttons and inputs namespace and include the text box component and button component with the content subscribe. I set the text box input type as text. Then, I add a placeholder property so that the text box component displays a short description about the input field. Also, I have defined a few CSS styles for this footer within this style section. If you look at the output page now, you can see the subscribe newsletter dialog. Next, I will show you how to add multiple dialogs. Here, I want to show a success message in the dialog after the subscribe button is clicked. So, first I add one more Blazor dialog component with the properties, height, width, and target with appropriate values. Then, I define the header and content definition within this dialog template section. I set header as success and the content as thank you for subscribing inside the division element. As I said before, I am going to display the success dialog after the subscribe button is clicked. Therefore, I add an on-click event with the appropriate handler to the button component of subscribe dialog. Initially, the success dialog visibility should be false, so I define the Boolean variable success dialog visibility is false and assign this variable to bind visible property of the success dialog. Next, I will define the event handler subscribe button click and set the success dialog visibility as true. In the dialog, I enter an email address and click the subscribe button. The success dialog is displayed with the message, "Thank you for subscribing." Next, I will show how to add close button to the success dialog. To add a close button to the success dialog, I will define the dialog button inside the dialog buttons tag. Then, I will add the content as close, and the is primary option is true. Look at the success dialog, the close button is displayed. If I want to close the success dialog and reset the text box value, then I will add an on-click event with an appropriate handler to the close button of success dialog. Now, I need to access the text box object of the subscribe dialog to reset the text box value, so let me add a reference to the text box component code and define its instance here. Next, I will define a string variable text box value and assign it to the bind value property of the text box component in the subscribe dialog. Within this close button click method, if the text box value is not empty, I will set the success dialog visibility to false and the text box value as empty. Then, I will call the state has changed method to send notification that the text box component state has changed. If I click the close button, the text value is reset and the success dialog is closed. By default, the dialog is displayed in the center of the target container. If I want to change the dialog position, then I define the dialog position data with the properties x and y. For the x property, I can set the value to left, center, right, or any offset value. And for the y property, the value can be top, center, bottom, or any offset value. I want to render the dialog at the top left, so I set the x value as left and the y value as top. And now, you can see the dialog displayed at the top left of the output page. Next, I will show you how to drag and resize the dialog. To drag and resize the dialog, I will define the allow dragging and enable resize properties with the value true. Looking now, you can easily drag and resize the dialog. Suppose I want to resize the dialog in all directions, then I define the list array dialog resize directions and add the resize direction all item to it. Now, I assign this list variable to the resize handles property. You can see in the dialog, you can resize the dialog in all directions. Finally, I will show you how to animate the dialog control. First, I need to define the dialog animation settings tag within this dialog code. Then, I will define the property effect inside the dialog animation settings tag. The Blazor dialog control supports 16 different effects. I am going to flip the dialog up, so I set the effect to flip X up. Looking at the output page now, the dialog gets flipped in the upward direction. In this video, we have seen how to customize the Create Custom Dialog and add multiple dialogs using the Blazor dialog control. We have also seen how to drag, resize, and animate the dialog. If you would like to see this working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you for watching.